itself, the reading of the scripture by itself, should give a lot of desire to do God's will. It seems like the more the word of God being taught, the more the people testing. Okay. Now that's where it should have been in the first place. Thank you. As I told you, it seemed like the more God sends his word, the more the people rebel against God's word. They don't like God. I don't know why anyone that doesn't like God's word want to go to heaven. Why would you want to go to heaven and you don't like what he has sent here? Can anybody tell me? Why you want to go to heaven, but you want to live like the world is? Don't you want to be with the world? Come on, y'all. Don't you want to be with the world? You go where the world goes. You do what the world does. You want to be hip with the world. You want to be on it. I know that's your word, sister. Just to keep you to know, Sister Tyler. Hip, I know. You know what hip means. You want to be on it with the world. You want to do it with the world. But you want to go to heaven. That don't make sense. And you ain't even scared.
Oh, now that's not true.
Because you're going to heaven anyway. Now, when I tried that, I was so scared. Did you hear what I said? Mm-hmm. When I tried that, I was so scared. And I didn't even know what the Bible said. Mm-hmm. But I was so scared. Now, some of you all were brought up in the sanctified church. And you were scared. Amen. You didn't know anything about the sanctified church, especially like I knew it, or what I was taught. But some of the things that you did, you were absolutely frightened by what you were doing, and you didn't want to be caught out there doing it if the Lord should come. And you didn't know anything about the holiness church. You only knew your church. Am I telling it right? Am I telling it right, y'all? I'm talking to the older folk. Excuse me. Senior citizens. Did you all were brought up different than me. Am I correct? But you didn't want to get caught out there. You knew what you were doing was wrong. And no sanctified person did you expect to be out there. Am I correct? If you saw anybody that was going to the sanctified church almost just passing by, you wanted to know what they doing over there. Am I right? Now, I've been in church all my life. But here we know what God wants. We read it. It's taught to us. It's given to us. We know exactly what God wants. It isn't a question in our mind what God wants. Even our young people are understanding what God wants. But they have no fear of God. That's what Hosea is saying. They got no fear of him. Wait till you read the rest of Hosea. You ain't seen nothing yet. Wait till God get angry. He's upset now with Hosea, in Hosea. So far in the scriptures, he's upset. And he's talking to Israel, Ephraim, Samaria, Judah. He's talking to them and telling them what they need to do. And they're looking at him and they're laughing. They're laughing. God is calling them. And they're laughing. They think God is crazy. They're hanging with the world. And they're doing their thing. Amen? Now, when I was slipping and doing that, I was so scared that I had to get to the church. I had to get to the church because I was scared I might get caught. And I got to the church and repented. Nothing happened. The devil said, see? Didn't nothing happen? Nothing happened. He said, come on. What the pastor talked about, God's going to strike you down? He said, that ain't happening. He's just talking. He's trying to scare you. This is straight up. Y'all know what straight up means today, don't you?
Yes, sir.
He said, I want to make sure I was in the right generation. Straight up. The devil said, didn't nothing happen? Come on, you can do it again. He said, I know how you felt because the preacher told you that. So, you start to slip again. And you try it again, and you get scared, you run back again. But each time you did it, guess what? Each time you did it, the less afraid you were to do it again. But the more you went to church, and the preacher told you what was going to happen to you, the less you believed it. Come on now, am I talking right?
Amen.
Until you became so comfortable now that the preacher just talking through his act. The Lord ain't coming. He ain't like he's coming tomorrow. He's going to come. But it ain't like he's going to come. Because see, even the preacher planning on going to Jackson. He ain't gonna miss that elevation.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's telling the Lord, hold up to the elevation. So we ain't got nothing to worry about. Because the preacher's telling the Lord to wait till he gets consecrated. Amen? So, we can be pretty assured that the Lord ain't coming before Friday. maybe right after Friday. But the preacher got to get this elevation first. I wish somebody was listening to me.
Thank you, Jesus.
I wish somebody was listening to me. I must be talking through my head. That's why it's so easy to not do what God wants you to do. Now, you might be here hearing me tonight and listening to me. But I guarantee you, it's happened to you. Anybody want to challenge me? Satan talked to you. Now those, you want to challenge me? Oh, I thought you had your hand up.
Now you see it.
Those that won't come and don't come and can find a good excuse not to come, he's really got them. And what they are saying in their heart to me, without saying it to me, which they are not saying it to me. You got that? Mm-hmm. Or should I try that again? Should I start from the top? You understood that? They're not saying it to me. They're saying, I don't care what you just tried to get me to come to church, I don't know, because you want that money. And I'm not bringing any more money to church than what I've given. So you might as well be happy with what I've given already. Mm. Amen? Am I correct? You ain't gonna get me to come to church no more than I'm coming. I can't spend all my life in church. I got a life to live. People told me that. I got a life to live. And my life is not involved up or tied up in church. Isn't that awesome? That your life is not tied up in church? Then what is it tied up in?
All right,
now I had that cup told me. I got other things to do, Elder Hope. And my church, my life is not all tied up in church. Guess who you told that?
God.
Huh?
God.
You told me. You told me and you didn't even open your mouth when you told me. Because he told me, you told me. You want me to show you where he told me? Ezekiel. Ezekiel. And then I'm opening the floor to question. Because I must show you what the scripture says. Listen what he says, and then I'll open the floor to your questions. 33 and 30. Start at the 29th verse.
Then shall they know.
Then shall they know
that I am the Lord.
You see what God keeps saying to you? You don't know who he is. But he's telling Ezekiel that when he tells him what he said, when it comes to pass, they're going to know that he is God. You're going to know it. Right now, you don't know it. Because he said what? Then. Then is when?
Later.
Yesterday.
No, then
later.
Is later. Yesterday, now you know. Tomorrow is then. Have I got it correct? So God says, then you'll know. Read.
That I am the Lord.
That I am the Lord.
When I have laid the land most desolate.
And I have laid, when I have laid the land most desolate.
Because of all their abominations.
Because of all their abominations.
They have committed.
That they have committed. This is the Lord. You know, Elder Hope, you don't preach like the other preachers preach.
Thank you.
Come on, somebody, give God some glory.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Touch your neighbor too. Next to you, tell him, God is good to me.
Amen.
Go run around and tell everybody how good God is to you. Don't you know you a saint of the Most High God? How many of y'all on y'all way? Read.
Then shall they know that I am the Lord.
Then shall they know that I am the Lord.
When I have laid the land,
Most desolate.
Because of all their
abominations.
Which they have committed.
Which they have committed.
Also.
Thou Son of Man.
The children of thy people.
Still are talking against thee.
By the walls.
Wait a minute. Did you hear that? Did you hear what he said? What did he say?
You're talking against me.
Huh? They're talking against you. But they're still talking against you. So they were talking against you before too.
He said, you're talking against me. I told you, you didn't open your mouth, but you're telling me. You were telling me to him, and he told me, because you weren't talking to God about me, amen. You were not talking to God, telling God that I make you sick, and you don't even think you're gonna go back to church because you're just tired of hearing it. Amen?
All right.
So God told me you were talking against me. You didn't tell me that. Isn't that right? Do I got this right? Read that verse again.
Also thou son of man.
Also thou son of man.
Children of thy people.
The children of thy people.
Still are talking against thee. By the walls. And in the doors of the houses. Speak one to another. Everyone to his brother. Saying, come.
I pray you.
Hear what is the word. That cometh from the Lord.
Now. They said what? We want to hear what's coming from the Lord. Amen. You told them, let's go hear what the Lord has said.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the way you say it. Read.
And they come unto thee. As the people cometh.
They sit before thee as my people.
And they hear thy words.
And they hear thy words.
But they will not do them.
But they will not do them.
But with their mouth.
Woo. Do you hear that? Who's talking here?
God is speaking through Ezekiel.
Who's talking?
God is talking.
Who's he talking about?
He's talking about the
preacher. Who's he talking about?
He's talking about the church too.
Who's he talking about?
Us.
The children of thy people.
Read.
They sit before thee as my people.
They sit before thee as my people.
And they hear thy words.
And they hear thy words.
They will not do them.
But they will not do them.
For with their mouth.
For with their mouth.
So much love.
They show much love.
But their heart goeth after their
covetousness. But their heart goeth after their covetousness. Do you know what covetousness means?
To want or desire another else's
stuff. You go after your desires. Somebody said, I covet your prayers. They're saying, I want your prayers. This is like saying, I covet your purse. I covet your money. I want your money. They go after their covetousness. Read.
And lo. Thou art unto them.
Thou art unto them.
As
a very lovely song.
One that hath
a pleasant voice.
And can play well.
And can play well on an instrument.
They hear thy words.
For they hear thy words.
They do them not.
But they do them not.
And when this cometh to pass.
When this cometh to pass.
Lo, it will come.
Lo, it will come.
Then shall they know.
Then shall they know.
That
a prophet.
Hath been among them.
In other words, right now. They don't know that the Lord sent me. They don't know that God has sent me here. It's just like I was talking to one, and they said, they were telling me, I said, won't you tell the Lord that? They said, I talk to him every day. I said, good. Tell him. He said, I talk to him every day. Now, what do you think God is telling him? Nothing. They just talking. God don't waste his time. God don't waste it. Floor's open. Got a question. Nobody got a question? Sister Pope.
It's funny because you're alluding to this in after prayer. If you have the Holy Ghost, is there a scripture that says it is a sin if you don't do anything? There are several scriptures that tell you what you ought to do. And then even in your introduction, you said that you don't see why you wouldn't do it. Why you wouldn't tell anybody. But is there a scripture, like if you have the Holy Ghost, is it a sin if you don't do anything? Not only if you don't do anything wrong, you know, but you just don't do anything. You just sit and don't do anything. Is there a scripture that condemns you if you do nothing? And all, I know you put you ought to do, but it's a sin if you don't do anything.
I think it's in Corinthians. He that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. That is the scripture I'm looking for.
But isn't that more in the decision-making realm of the scriptures?
I thought it was in 2 Corinthians, but I don't seem to see it at the present time. Find that for me.
Okay.
He that knoweth to do good. And doeth it not.
James 4:17.
Is it James? No wonder I can't find it. I thought it was in Corinthians. Well, let's see now. Since there are no other questions, there is another question.
Yes.
Sister Hope, would you begin to read it the 13th verse?
Go to now. Ye that say.
Today or tomorrow.
We will go into such a city. And continue there a year. And buy and sell. And get gain.
We're going to vacation for a year. And we're going to get gain. Read.
Whereas ye know not. What shall be on tomorrow.
But what is your life?
It is even a vapor. That appeareth for a little time. And then vanisheth away. But that ye ought to say.
If the Lord will.
We shall live. And do this or do that. But now ye rejoice in your boasting. All such rejoicing is evil. Therefore. To him that knoweth to do good.
And doeth it not.
To him it is sin.
You know what to do. You know what you should be doing. But you sit down and do nothing, or you refuse to do what should be done. It's a sin. Did I misquote it? Did I misinterpret it?
I would question the context.
Why would you question the context?
Because this is speaking of an intentional.
What's your question again?
If you have the Holy Ghost, and you are a member in good standing of the church, and you don't serve, you don't do anything, but you're not doing anything wrong. Here, this is preceded by you doing something wrong. But now ye rejoice in your boasting. All such rejoicing is evil. So this one is predicated on...
No, it ain't predicated.
It's preceded.
It can be used as that. You wanted to say exactly what you wanted to say. To predicate it in a plan.
I'm
saying in your mind. I'm not saying you're not saying what the word says.
Mm-hmm.
You're saying that it can only be used predicated upon those doing wrong. Not so.
Okay.
He tells you, but now you rejoice in your boasting. All such boasting is evil.
Mm-hmm.
Now he comes back and says, therefore, to him that knoweth to do good. Mm-hmm. Now what are you talking about? Those in church filled with the Holy Ghost know there's work to be done and they don't do it. They just sit. They don't go out and do nothing wrong.
Right.
They're not going out sinning, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
They just don't do anything. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Another scripture, work while it is day, for the night cometh when no man can work. I believe that's in Matthew. Work while it is day, for the night cometh, and no man can work. The day is while there's grace. Night is rapture. You're gone. It's too late now to do anything.
Well, I thought it was while you're in your youth.
No. You can apply it in that area.
Mm-hmm.
But work while it is day, while there's grace, while there's light to work, while there's time to work.
Mm-hmm.
The night coming,
no man can work.
And then no time to work. You can't see the work now.
Without faith, without works, is dead.
Faith without works is dead. To do nothing is a sin. Don't see, God's word is applicable in every situation if you read it right. Don't confide it to what you're thinking.
That's John 9:4.
What does it say?
As long as it is day, we must do the works of him who sent. I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. The night cometh when no man can work.
That's when God takes the church out. And then it's night. And your work won't pay. You see, one time in this country, nobody worked at night. You go through you're traveling at night, and you go through a city, you ain't got no gas. What did you have to do? You better hope you got somewhere where there's light and near a gas station and wait till the station open up in the morning. That wasn't too long before I started driving. All right? That wasn't long before I started driving that they did that. If you didn't get gas before night, you was in trouble. Because the gas station closed 10, 11 o'clock at night, and that was it. Detroit was closed on Sunday. Anybody was in this? There was no stores open. If you wanted a box of cornflakes, you had to wait till Monday. Are y'all listening to me?
Amen.
Night cometh, and no man what? Can work.
I must work the work of him that sent me.
While it is day. That is grace.
Mm-hmm. When no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world.
That's grace.
Mm-hmm.
Sister Hope.
Well, it's part of the work we read in Sunday school. Haggai 2:4. Yet now be strong, O Zerubbabel, saith the Lord, and be strong, O Joshua, son of Josedek, the high priest, and be strong, all ye people of the land, saith the Lord, and work, for I am with you, saith the Lord of hosts. So you have to do something, because he called us to work.
Sister Hope.
Well, when she's talking about people that had the Holy Ghost not doing anything, well, this might not apply. But the one that, scripture that popped in my mind was Revelation 21:8. But the fearful and unbelieving, those are the first two in line, Jesus, shall have their part in the lake, which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. They're afraid to maybe change their ways or to leave their church or whatever, or they just don't want to believe the truth. They don't do anything. They just live.
They just exist. What does Luke 12:47 say?
And that servant which knew his Lord's will and prepared not himself, neither did according to his will, shall be beaten with many stripes. That's 47.
Take your time and read it again. What's that? What did I say?
Well, Luke 12:47.
Luke 12:47. Wait a minute, let me get there. Because see, you have to read it slow sometimes to get the juice out of it. Read.
And that servant. Which knew his Lord's will. And prepared not himself.
Neither did according to his will.
Shall be beaten with many stripes.
Read.
But he that knew not. And did commit things. Worthy of stripes.
Shall be beaten with few. He's gonna be beaten anyway. With few stripes.
For unto whomsoever much is given.
Of him shall much be required.
And to whom men have committed much.
Of him they will ask the more. I think that should answer the question. Either one of them will answer the question. People want to come to church. They want to sit in church. They say, I showed up at church on Sunday. I paid my tithes and I left. Well, what did you do?
It's not even a bad attitude. It's just that I got the Holy Ghost, so I'm good.
Yeah. That's a bad attitude. What if your child gets up every morning, clean up, washes, bathes himself, keeps himself nice, him or herself, and does nothing? Does absolutely nothing. He's clean, or she is clean. They'll do nothing. They don't sweep. They take their bad clothes, send it down to clothes you for you to wash. They don't do nothing. Absolutely, positively nothing. That's a record.
Thank
you, Jesus. What is that? Is it?
Nothing from that.
Come on, girl.
But the guy said absolutely nothing. I forgot who.
Oh, war. Yes.
Oh,
what is it good for? Absolutely nothing.
Sister Ferguson.
First, my question, then the viewer's question.
Yes, first, your question.
Yes, please.
Then the viewer.
Yes.
Oh, or somebody asked a question?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
First, my question. This goes back to Sunday school on yesterday, and Sister Ware spoke.
You got to speak loud now. Don't go under your breath. You start going, you started out here, and then you start going down.
Sister Ware spoke on the chip. My question is, how are they going to, that's kind of confusing to me. How are they going to do it? You think they already did it? We went in surgery and they snuck it in? Or how do you think they're going to do it?
Do what?
Put the chip in.
Put the chip in you?
Mm-hmm.
You going to let them?
How?
When you can't buy nor sell. The only way you can get anything, you can't use a credit card. And the only way you can buy anything, because you won't have any cash,
right,
you're going to have to let them put the chip in.
Well, I won't be here at that time.
You sure now?
I hope not, in the name of Jesus.
You better stay in church.
Amen. Okay, the viewer's question is...
who is the viewer?
I don't know if we can... It's
Dennis Thompson.
Oh, Denise? Thompson.
Dennis.
Oh, Dennis Thompson. He said, well, he quoted a scripture. He said, Hebrews 11:3, it says, by faith we understand that the worlds were framed. Are there other worlds somewhere else? But his question, because I said, your question, please. And then he said, my question is there another world somewhere?
He said 11 what?
3.
Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. So he asked, are there other worlds? In my book, as I get reference, it speaks of other ages. It speaks of other ages. Now, but if he thought there were other galaxies or other Earths, if that's what he's looking at, other Earths like the one that we live on, God only made the Earth to be inhabited.
Mm-hmm.
Find that for me real quick. It's in, it is in Isaiah. He made the Earth to be inhabited. But when it speaks of worlds, it speaks of ages.
And like ages, it's like
A-G-E-S.
Okay.
A-G-E-S.
Okay.
Ages.
It's Isaiah 45:18.
45:18. Isaiah 45. Y'all didn't know I didn't know every scripture, did you? But I know enough of them. 45:18. Says, for thus saith the Lord that created the heavens, God himself that formed the earth, and made it. He hath established it. You're talking about the earth. He created it, not in vain. He formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord. and there is none else. So if he thought there were other worlds in the sense that there were other planets that was inhabited like the earth, no, there aren't any others. Because God says he created the earth to be inhabited. And they've searched Mars. It ain't to be inhabited. They searched Venus. It is not to be inhabited. They took the, telescope.
Hubble.
The Hubble telescope. And they looked as far as the Hubble could see. To the end of the galaxy, as they call it. And they couldn't find another one. Ain't nobody else out there but us.
All right.
That answers the question?
Yes. He wanted to know. Sorry. If there was another Earth or galaxy, you basically answered it.
I've answered that one already. The Bible won't answer that.
Yeah. I gave him the scripture.
Well, if he's listening, he heard it. He just, that's where he heard us, wasn't it?
Well, we don't know who's tuned in.
I'm posting it.
They're asking on social media. We don't know who's tuned in. I see somebody is, but we don't know who it is.
All right. Yes.
My question is, when it comes to the world, you talked about it before anybody was living on the earth, it was the world, and it became the earth when people were living on it. So would the other planets be considered as worlds, but ours is the earth because there are inhabitants on it?
I don't think so. I just think that it becomes worlds in the sense of understanding at a particular age of time. There was no other one created. God is God all by himself. And if he didn't leave a record of somebody else, it ain't there. If God didn't leave it, it isn't there. Amen?
Amen.
Sister Holloway.
The definition of world is...
The definition of world.
A world is a common name for a human civilization, specifically human experience, history of the human condition in general. So it's human life, the civilization of a human. If it's other forms of life, it's not considered as world.
It's the times of when human life goes through.
Right.
And the knowledge they had at that particular time, I'm expanding on it.
Right.
And as it moves on, as the young folk will say, that was your world. That's the way we live in our world.
Amen. Human experience.
The one that I just told you all about, where folks believe the preacher without knowing anything about the Bible. Mm-hmm. That was our world.
Right.
But now we in your world. You said you're smarter than we are. Amen? You are more educated than we are. Am I correct? How many of you old folks got college educations? One. How many of you young folk been to college? Outnumbered.
That was a different question.
Outnumbered. How many have furthered their education? How many of you older folk should I say, furthered your education beyond high school. Older folk is in my age.
Right.
Ooh.
I know. I
ain't raised you. 60 and above.
Nope.
Oh. You wanted to get specific. You wanted to get specific. If you keep quiet, as I said, open mouth, stick foot in.
That was a good one.
That was pretty good.
Well,
open mouth, stick foot in. Sister Blanche.
I got two questions.
One at a time now.
Okay, since they were talking about other worlds and stuff, what do you think that the Lord got all the rest of those planets and stuff out there for?
Us?
For us?
Yeah. That's the heavens.
Oh, okay.
We can't go there in this body.
Right. Okay.
When we change our bodies, the flesh keeps us earthbound.
So, and if we didn't have the flesh, then we'd probably be all over the place, right?
Absolutely.
Because
we'd be able to go wherever God's realm is. Mm-hmm. Is ours.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It's ours. At the present time, this is how come I said, When the one answered, it was the glorified church.
Mm-hmm.
The church isn't glorified yet.
Right.
We are the church.
So if.
But when the church is glorified, mm-hmm. can't nothing hold us down.
Right. All right. Thank you, Jesus.
We are truly free.
Yeah. Yes,
I can live on Mars, Venus.
Yeah.
I can live on the sun if I want to.
Yeah.
Right. And it will not burn me. See, the sun burns my flesh.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I can't lay out on the beach. I went to Bahamas. Got a suntan. Dark as I is, I got a suntan in the Bahamas. My daddy was there. He's a dark man.
He got
a suntan.
Thank you, Jesus.
But I can lay in the sun in Detroit and I'll get a little darker.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot. Mm-hmm. But in Bermuda, I burn.
Mm-hmm.
I burn. Mm-hmm. Believe me, I better take the next time I go to Bahamas, I'm taking suntan. Mm-hmm.
Oh, you going again?
Sunblock.
Yeah. You going
again? Sunblock, excuse me. I'm taking sunblock. I don't know if I'm going again. I like to go again. But next time I'm taking sunblock. But there was a man in Bahamas. He was black. I mean blue black. He was knitting his neck in the sun. It didn't bother him. I said he was blue black. He had a blue shine. Did you see, you heard him talk about blue steel? That's black steel that shines, that gives a blue glow. Ain't nothing wrong with being black.
The black of the berry.
Ain't nothing wrong with being black. Black folks in America ain't black.
That's right.
That's true.
It's just that the white folk call them black.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And we can't teach them any different.
Right.
So we say, okay, we'll be black.
All right.
If it makes you happy, we'll be black.
Yeah.
But we ain't black.
That's right.
No.
We're all different. We can't claim black.
Well, some of us can.
Yeah, very few.
Yeah.
Even the blackest one you see here wasn't as black as the one I saw in Muhammad.
The blue black.
Purple, whatever you call it. I call it blue black because if you can see a blue sheen.
It's blurple.
See, I mean, he was sitting in the sun. It's a wonder that Ashley didn't get black.
Wow.
She was in the study. That's all the time she's been there, but I'm just saying.
It doesn't count.
That's how hot it was.
That doesn't count. We got to go back.
Always.
We got to do it again.
You can stand.
Whatever. Me and Mother Blanny. We're going
to get it. Sister
all
Blanny.
All members of my family are yellow.
You're in church.
Let him alone. Let them alone, sister. No, I have mercy.
It's your family.
What's your question, Sister Blair?
I remember from time to time you always say that we are in a stupor, half awake and half asleep. So, how do we get out of it? Being in a stupor.
How do you awake out of a stupor, what you're asking? You ever been half awake and half asleep?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you know what a stupor is. Mm-hmm. What did you have to do to come out of it?
Go to the bathroom, wash my face, and
you had to wake yourself up. You had to make yourself get up.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now I'm taking you step by step. Mm-hmm. You had to awaken yourself.
Mm-hmm.
See, I was laying on the bed today. I wanted to get up and go do some things that I had to do before it got too late. But I got up early, and the rest of them was in bed. So I sat up, and I watched, because I couldn't go back to sleep. I watched the news this morning. And then I got sleepy, and I was laying on the bed. And I wasn't really sound asleep, but then I was. So I asked you to come in. I thought you were going such and such a place. I woke up. I was going to go. She said, come on, you better get ready. And then she left out the room. This is no Clifton. Clifton. Yeah, what you want? I thought you said you had to go somewhere. I said, yeah, I'm going to get up from here. And I'm going to take my shot. I'm laying on the edge of the bed. On back on my bed at foot, not in it, laying across it. And she went out the room. I guess they said, forget it. And so I knew I was supposed to get up. And I'm trying, all while I'm laying, I'm trying to get up.
The bed was hugging you, wasn't it?
I know.
I'm trying. I know I got to get up. I'm asleep.
Arms wrapped around.
I'm asleep. I'm asleep, y'all. I'm asleep. And I'm trying to get up. And finally, I just said, no. I shook myself. And I sat up on the edge of the bed.
Come on.
I sat there. I said, I'm coming out of the stupor.
All right.
And then I said, I wanted to lay back down. I said, if I lay back down, I ain't going to get nothing done. I know I ain't going to get it done. Times are gone. I don't even know how long I laid there in the stupor trying to get up. I'm trying to. I know they just think I'm just laying there, but I'm laying there actually trying to get up off that bed, get dressed, and go do what I got to do. I finally broke loose, and I went in the bathroom and leaned on the sink. And some said, go back and lay down. I shut the bathroom door.
I know, right? I know.
I had my pajamas on. But what I did do, I took my pajamas off while I went in the bathroom. So all I had was my underwear.
Link this TMI.
I hope I ain't telling too much. But anyway.
He already told it.
I'm just trying to tell you how it is. I'm standing in the bathroom and it's telling me to go back and lay down. That's how I'm feeling. I took my underclothes off. Now I put them down the clothes shoe.
I can't go back out.
I can't go back out the bathroom.
So you're making yourself.
Because Ashley's in the house. Uh-huh. I can't walk around like that.
Amen.
All right? So what have I got to do? Before I can put my clean ones on,
you gotta get in that shower.
I got to get in the shower. You understand what I'm saying? Do you understand the steps? If you're in a stupor, with the work of God, you don't want to wake up. You got to wake yourself up.
All right now.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. You got to take off some of that stuff you got on.
All right.
And you got to get in God's shower.
Yes, sir.
All right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And you got to clean up.
Yes, come on, preacher.
Thank you.
Come on, that was good. Come on.
Since I got to make it, Brother Crowder, you got it? Brother Crowder, you got to go?
What time?
You got to go?
Not yet.
Well, have a seat.
It depends on what time.
Have a seat. I put myself in a situation.
Thank you, Jesus.
Where I had to get in the shower.
All right.
In order for me to go back out, I'm going to put my clean clothes on and I ain't showered.
All right.
To put my clean clothes on, I got to shower. Mm-hmm. And if I shower, I'm going to get clean.
All right.
I'm going to wake up.
All right.
Under the shower.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I'm going to get my blood.
Yeah.
To move it.
All right, now.
That's right.
I'm going to get my body in a shape.
Uh-huh.
I got that moving and the time is moving. Uh-huh. Now I'm watching the clock.
Right.
Now I got to hurry up and get my clothes on.
Now
I'm late. I got to hurry up. I got to go.
Yeah.
But I was never fully, completely, restfully sleeping. I knew I was on that bed and I wasn't supposed to be there.
Okay.
I knew I wasn't supposed to be, I was supposed to be getting up and getting dressed.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I was in a stupor. And I knew that I was supposed to be getting up. And I knew time was passing me by.
Uh-oh.
I got to be in Bible class tonight.
All right.
Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying, Sister Blatt? You got to wake yourself up out of it.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I'm going to Bible class.
Mm-hmm.
Every time the devil tells you you ain't going, you get your clothes on, you get in the car, and you say, I'm going.
Exactly what I do. You have to create a sense of urgency.
Well, you have to do it yourself.
Yeah.
He
did
try to stop me.
He always. I did not want to get up off the bed.
Good example. Yeah.
I did not want to get up. I made myself get up.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I was asleep now.
Mm-hmm.
On the bed. My wife did not come back to wake me up. Neither did Ashley.
Mm-hmm.
They left me alone.
Mm-hmm.
They kind of fussed at me when I told them, Herb, we got to get out of here. We got to go.
Thank you, Jesus.
But you understand, I knew what I had to do.
Right.
I knew what day I was in.
Mm-hmm.
I was on Monday, open for Bible class.
Yeah.
knew I had to be here at 7 o'clock.
Now you know I'm
late. I looked at 12 o'clock before I laid down. I said, I'm going to lay in for a few minutes.
Just a few minutes. Get you every time.
Yeah.
That's what we do. I'm just going to do this, but I'm going to church. I'm not going to let the devil get me. I'm not going to let the devil trick me. Amen?
Amen.
You going in that stupor. Time is quickly going. Unless y'all got some more questions.
You know how we got one.
Y'all want Sister Polk to ask her a question?
No.
I have a real question at home. I had the wrong Bible. I had to get a Bible.
But,
I
could
call him. He said we
could
call him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You said it.
I said, nobody.
I can take care of that.
This medicine is not what she is.
Nobody has. Now, see what I'm saying now? He has to call me.
Right.
Because he's in Washington. I'm saying you here, and you won't even go to Bible class again.
Okay.
We still call.
Amen.
Amen.
You got access to me all the time, and you won't even use the access that you have.
All right.
That's all I'm saying.
Amen.
You have it better than he had.
Amen.
I just wanted to say that. I hope that this has been a good Bible class.
Amen.
Amen.
I hope it has been. You have to understand who you are and whose you are.
Amen.
And what is happening to you.
Amen.
In order for you, the Bible says, awake out of sleep.
Mm-hmm.
All right? It tells you to awake out of your sleep. So you got to awake out of your sleep. I don't care what your age group is. The devil will put you to sleep. Everybody has laid on the bed and knew this all while they were on the bed. They knew they shouldn't be there. Amen? They know they should have gotten up. Amen?
Amen?
They know that they should have gotten up off that bed. But they stayed there. When somebody came and woke them up, either they said, you should have got me up soon. Or they said, man, I should have got up soon.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen?
I should have stayed there. They didn't think it was the next day. And somebody that slept that hard, they were truly asleep.
Yes.
But most of the time, you're laying there. You know what day it is. And you know that you got something to do that day, but you're laying on the bed, wanting somebody to awaken you out of your sleep. You want them to wake you up. You're waiting for them to wake you up. Amen?
Amen.
You ever been that way, sleeping on the bed?
Mm-hmm.
And you wanted somebody to wake you up?
No.
Don't tell me you've been on the bed and you knew you weren't supposed to be there and you didn't want nobody to wake you up. You wanted somebody to wake you up.
If you're trying to go somewhere.
Especially if you knew somebody else was in the house. If you were there by yourself, you wanted to wake yourself up. And you were asleep. And yet you wanted to wake up, but you wouldn't give in. No, brother, you kept giving in to the desire to sleep. Amen?
Amen.
Does that make sense?
Yes,
so if you understand natural things, the spiritual things won't be hard to come into understanding.
Amen.
Now, we thank God for your being here. I love teaching the Bible class. I know everybody don't love my teaching, but I love you.
Amen.
I definitely love you, Apostolic Church of
Deacons.
Every one of you.
Amen.
Because I don't want any of you lost. I don't want none of you lost. And especially, I don't want nobody standing before the Lord and say, Elder Clifton didn't tell me.
All right.
I love you. Even the ones that don't come and talk to you about me. Don't tell me they don't talk to you about me. I've been in church too long.
They don't talk to me about you.
First of all, I know what folks saints do in church, and then the Bible tells me. So it ain't no sense to you telling me folk don't come to you and tell you about me and tell you how tired they are of me. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
But you got to understand, that's to kill you first.
That's right. That's right.
Thank you, Jesus.
They don't like you.
That's right.
Because they don't want you coming to church.
Thank you.
Because when you come to church, you make them look bad.
Well, all right.
Right.
Listen, when you come to church and you tell them about church, you make them mad. I dare you to tell them, say, girl, boy, man, Bible class was awesome.
You sure missed
it. Bible class was awesome. I'm telling you, I'm so glad I went to Bible class. I don't know what to do. They're going to look at you and probably take your temperature.
Thank you, Jesus.
And go get a meter and take your blood pressure.
Amen.
If you tell them that you enjoyed Bible class,
yeah.
Thank
you. Amen.
Yeah.
Thank
you. You what? I enjoyed Bible class. And I ain't talking about the friends that ain't never been here.
That's right.
I'm talking about the ones that been knowing me.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm talking about the ones in here that I'm being elevated to something official. Mm-hmm. They are totally tore up.
Thank you, Lord.
He's
thank
what?
Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Jesus. Suffragan Bishop.
Yep, it happened after you left.
Mm-hmm. What?
It happened after they left.
You being Suffragan Bishop. He ain't got but that little old bitty hole in the wall.
They were holding him back.
Right.
And they left.
They was holding us back.
They what?
They was holding us back.
They said, he ain't got but that hole in the wall and he's suffering. How in the world is he suffering his bishop?
Because God did it.
Now, everybody else outside the church that knows District Elder Hope, they said, you should have been there a long time ago. You should have been suffragan bishop a long time ago.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
That's what they're telling
me.
The other one, they look at me and say, congratulations, this is got a whole division. I know they say, how in the world are you making? Hey, I know what they're saying. I don't have to run around asking what they're saying. There's some that truly are congratulatory toward me because of my elevation. They are, I know they are truly glad to see me elevated. And there's others that question to no end. Why should I be elevated? I was talking to the bishop of the diocese Sunday. I shouldn't have been because we was in the pulpit.
Mm-hmm.
But that was my chance to get him. And I asked him some questions. And he told me. And he said, we got to talk about who helped God make man.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me. Wisdom, knowledge, he was talking to his attributes.
Mm-hmm.
Grace. I said, that's his church. I said, that's his church. If it wasn't a noise in there, everybody would have heard me. He said, oh. I said, the church is the wisdom of God.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
He fell back and said, no. He said, I said, that's the church. I said, the church is his body. What's he going to use to build the church? His body. So we have to understand. I don't care what they say. I know who elevates me.
Amen.
It doesn't come from the east or the west.
Right.
But it comes from the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You don't like it? That's your business.
All right. Yeah. All right.
When did God get through? I wish all of apostolic